In the world of pharmaceutical sales, the Lidoderm patch shines as a breakout performer. It's responsible for taking Endo Pharmaceuticals from a scrappy startup to a high-flying growth company in just 6 years.
Trying to see Dr. Howard?
All the way, Endo executives pushed and praised their sales force.
You've hit an all-time high with Lidoderm at over 54,500 scripts.
Expand that marketplace for Lidoderm.
Lidoderm at an all-time high number of total prescriptions.
Driving Lidoderm.
Great job, team.
To unparalleled success. More than $750 million in sales for 2010. But it's an unlikely position for a drug approved only to treat a very small group of patients.
They gamed the system from the beginning. It's cheating taxpayers out of a lot of money.
Peggy Ryan has been a top salesperson at Endo for the past decade. She came forward as a whistleblower nearly 7 years ago after becoming increasingly uncomfortable with the company's pressure for her to sell Lidoderm off-label for unapproved uses, something the company knows is illegal.
Ever since I began in April of 2002, there was much pressure to promote the Lidoderm patch off-label.
The Lidoderm patch is only approved by the FDA to treat post-herpetic neuralgia, PHN, a painful skin rash which is a complication of shingles. It affects mostly the elderly and has a very narrow market. By Endo's own account, no more than 200,000 new patients a year.
Part of the master scheme is that the Lidoderm patch is covered under orphan status.
Orphan status is an incentive the government gives to drug companies to produce products that treat rare diseases like PHN that affect small patient populations. In exchange, companies get tax incentives, a long patent life with no competition, and faster, easier FDA approval. All this to encourage a company to produce a drug with little profit potential. But as it turns out, Endo made billions on Lidoderm by breaking the rules.
Every taxpayer, every person in this country that pays taxes was harmed as a result of this activity.
It was just a lot of greed, and it continues to be a lot of greed.
They were breaking the law.
Very much part of the culture to sell off-label with Endo.
It wasn't inadvertent, wasn't an accident. They meant to do it.